Hi boys and girls, Miss Cody here again. Today we're gonna have a lot of fun doing a couple of different activities. Showing below you right now on this video are the materials that you're gonna need from your music kit or things that you can get from home. So for example, if I said that you needed rhythm sticks, you can use two pencils or some wooden spoons or anything else like that in order to do along our activity if you don't have your rhythm sticks at home with you. Same thing if you have you don't have the paper plates or the plastic plates that I gave you in your music kit, you can go ahead and find your own paper or plastic plates within your house or just use your hands. So have fun, make sure you have all your materials, pause the video right now to go and get them if you need to, and then you can continue on with our activities. Sometimes you might just need your Chromebook because I might be sending you to a website in order to do an activity there. Have fun.
Hey-ho, hi, hello, welcome friends and away we go. Now repeat after me, so, 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 so. Me.
Good job, boys and girls. We're going to start learning how to read the notes so and me on our staff. So you notice that the so is on the middle line and it's higher than our me, which is on the bottom line. So let's try another one. Look at it, figure it out. You know, you start high and then go low, low, and high again. So me, me, so. So, me, me, so. Good job. Remember, your higher note, the one that's on the middle, is our so. The one that's on the bottom is our me. And that way you can always see if it's a higher note, it's up here. If it's a lower, you're going to make sure you bring your voice down lower. Let's try one more. Look at it.
figure it out. I start low and then go high. Try it. Listen first. Mi, mi, so, mi. Mi, mi, so, mi. Were you able to follow along not just with your hand signs, but with following along on our staff music? That's awesome, because that's really what we want to get doing, is to be able to read the notes that we see on the lines of the staff. So good job if you were able to read the mi, mi, so, mi, and going low, low, high, low. Good job, boys and girls. We'll do some more of these soon. Okay, boys and girls, we have another beanbag activity today. Today, we're gonna take our beanbags and we're gonna do some exercising with them. So if you were in my music classes, you got a beanbag in your music kit, so please go and get those out right now. If you're not in my music class, or maybe you misplaced your beanbag, or perhaps you left it at school, you can go ahead and get any small stuffed animal or a beanie baby or something like that that you can use in place of our beanbag today, because we're gonna be doing some beanbag exercising. So pause the video and go and get what you need. Glad you were able to come on back, boys and girls. Let's go ahead and do our beanbag exercising. Follow along with me.
There's nothing like a good friend to share an exercise with. So pick up your beanbag, stand up, and let's start exercising with the beanbag stretch. Put the beanbag in your right hand and stretch your arm up as high as you can. And bring it back down. That's it.
Stretch up
and down. Stretch up
and down.
Stretch up and down.
Stretch up and down.
Now put the beanbag in your left hand and let's try it again.
Stretch up and down.
Stretch up and down.
Stretch up and down.
Good job. Now let's try the beanbag lift. Everyone, sit down, keep your legs out straight and feet close together. Put your beanbag on top of your feet. Lift your feet and the beanbag up, not too high, then bring them back down. Are you ready? Here we go.
Feet up and down.
Feet up and down.
Feet up and down.
Now everyone, jump up and hold your beanbag in your hand, because it's time to beanbag jog. Jog in place, not too fast, and keep those knees up.
Jogging in place is so happy and fun, fun, fun. Beanbag exercising.
You're doing great. Let's try the beanbag squeeze, exercising our hand and our fingers. Put the beanbag in your right hand and using all your fingers, squeeze it as hard as you can. Now, loosen up those fingers. That's it.
Squeeze, loosen up.
Squeeze, loosen up.
Squeeze, loosen up.
Now put the beanbag in your left hand and let's try that again. All together now.
Squeeze, loosen up.
Squeeze, loosen up.
Squeeze, loosen up.
That was great. I think you're ready to try the beanbag toe touch. Make sure you're standing up straight and tall and hold the beanbag with both hands. Bend down and touch the beanbag to your toes and try not to bend those knees, and then stand back up. All together now, here we go.
Bend, touch your toes, stand up. Bend, touch your toes, stand up.
All right, it's time to beanbag jog. So hold your beanbag in your hand and jog in place. Not too fast and keep those knees up.
Jogging in place is so healthy and fun.
So now it's time to take that well-deserved rest.
Ready? Jazz! Jazz! You built a musical robot? Cool. Can it play the new One Direction song? How about something by Taylor Swift? What do you mean that music isn't sophisticated enough? Oh, it's a jazz bot. Dear Tim and Moby, what is jazz? From Katie. Well, jazz is kind of hard to define. But with the help of Moby's little musical friend here, we can give you a quick introduction to the basics. Jazz originated in New Orleans, Louisiana, at the turn of the 20th century. It was played mainly by African-American musicians who combined several musical styles to create something totally new. They started out with a syncopated beat. Syncopation is when a musician changes around the natural rhythm of a piece of music. In syncopation, beats that are normally unstressed are emphasized. It's easier to understand when you listen to it. Hey, Jazzbot, can you play Mary Had a Little Lamb? Now can you play it with a syncopated rhythm? You hear the difference? That's syncopation. Jazz also borrowed from the blues, the traditional folk music of African Americans in the South. Blues is played with a unique musical scale that relies on blue notes, notes that are slightly lower pitched than they would be on a major scale. Hey Jazzbot, can you play a blues scale? Hear those blue notes? The early jazz pioneers borrowed this scale from the blues. Syncopation and the blues both came from African musical traditions, but jazz borrowed from European music too. Jazz musicians often play the same instruments as classical musicians, including the trumpet, trombone, clarinet, saxophone, and double bass. Well, the real key to jazz is improvisation. That's when musicians make up what they're playing while they're playing it. Usually they'll start by playing a simple melody or phrase. Then they'll play different variations on it, going wherever the music takes them. So basically, you could say that jazz is a type of music that includes syncopated rhythms and blue notes, and is based on improvisation. But that's only half the story. Jazz has changed and evolved a lot over the years. The traditional type of jazz that first came out of New Orleans is often called Dixieland. It peaked during the 1920s, when Louis Armstrong was recording with his bands, the Hot Five and the Hot Seven. In the 1930s, the most popular form of jazz was swing, which featured big bands and a strong rhythmic beat. Band leaders at that time included Count Basie and Benny Goodman. During this time, jazz vocalists like Ella Fitzgerald became famous by singing popular songs in a unique, jazzy way. Fitzgerald was famous for scat singing, improvising complicated vocal solos by singing nonsense syllables. In the 1940s, musicians like saxophonist Charlie Parker and trumpet player Dizzy Gillespie developed a new form of jazz called bebop. It was way faster and more complex than earlier forms of jazz. Jazz was the dominant form of American popular music from the 1920s all the way through World War II. Since then, musicians and composers have developed many different varieties of jazz. Often, they combine jazz with other musical genres. There's Latin jazz, free jazz fusion, smooth jazz, acid jazz folk, you name it. Anyway, that's the story of jazz. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to go download some disposable pop music. What? Can't move. You'll pay for this, Jazzbot.
The Duke and Ella. So let's have a wonderful...
Don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Do-a-do-a-do-a-do-a-do-a-do-a-do-a. It don't mean a thing, all you gotta do is sing. Do-a-do-a-do-a-do-a-do-a-do-a-do-a. Makes no difference if it's sweet or hot. Give that rhythm everything you've got. Oh, it don't mean a thing if you ain't got that swing. Do-a-do-a-do-a-do-a-do-a-do-a-do-a-do-a. It don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. All you gotta do is sing. Do I, 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 do I. Make no difference if that's sweet or hot. Give that rhythm everything you got. Don't need a thing if it ain't got that swing. Do I, 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 do I.
Thank you.
Here I go again. Here I go again. Here I go again. Here I go again. Taking a chance, taking a chance.
Jerry?
Here I go again. I hear those trumpets blow again. All aglow again. Taking a chance on love. Here I slide again. About to take that ride again. Starry-eyed again. Taking a chance on love. I thought that conjurer frame up I never would try. But now I'm taking the game up, and the ace of hearts is high. Things are mending now. I see a rainbow blending now. We'll have a happy ending now. Taking a chance on love.
Whoa.
I'm in a groove again. Taking a chance. Again, here I go again, taking a chance, taking a chance, taking a chance on love.
Hi, boys and girls. We're going to do some more with tongue twisters since you guys seem to have so much fun with them. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. A peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked. If Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers, where's the peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked? Let's try it again slowly. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. A peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked. If Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers, where's the peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked? Let's go a little faster. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. A peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked. If Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers, where's the peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked? Try it a little quicker, boys and girls. Here we go. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. A peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked. If Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers, where's the peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked? Let's go as fast as we can. Are you ready? Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. A peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked. If Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers, where's the peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked? Try it one more time, because even I get tongue twisted. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. A peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked. If Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers, where's the peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked?
Hello, people. Hello, friends. This is the show where the fun never ends. We've got beats and notes and everything that you'll ever need to know to play or sing. Come on in. Don't be shy.
Luigi's here.
And Mike's the guy. With all our friends, you're sure to be in the know. So welcome to the music. Welcome to the music. Welcome to the music show.
Welcome back to the music show, everybody. It's our final show of the season, and it promises to be a real cliffhanger.
I'm Mike the microphone.
I'm Cadence the drummer.
Fret the guitar here.
And I'm the star of the show, Luigi's Baton. Today, we are learning all about the staff and the names of the lines and spaces on it.
Whoa. That sounds very complicated, and it makes me very nervous.
No sweat, Fret. It's a piece of cake once you get the hang of it.
Then you'll be able to read music just like you know how to read a book.
That's right. If you can read music, you can make music.
And we'll teach you all right here on the music show where music is...
Fundamental!
If you can't beat them, join them.
You see, these five lines are called a staff.
It looks like a ladder.
That's right. And just like on a ladder, you can go up and down on a staff.
And the notes on every line and every space are assigned their own letter.
Which is like the name of each note.
See, the lines starting from the bottom have the letters E, G, B, D, and F.
You can remember them with a funny sentence like,
every good boy does fine.
Or, elephants get big dirty feet.
And the names of the spaces are really easy to remember, too, because they spell a word you might already know.
F-A-C-E.
Face. Oh, face! That spells face. Whoa, I'm very relieved.
Hey, everybody. How about a great song about the names of the lines and spaces? Will you sing it with me?
Sure. That's what we're here for.
Come on, let's get this place cooking.
Okay. A one, a two, a one, two, three, four.
Lines and spaces, baby. That's what it's all about. Lines and spaces, baby. Makes me wanna shout, hey! Every space and every line is a special friend of mine. Line their names and you'll do great. Come on, everybody, let's celebrate. Spaces and lines.
Do it again.
Spaces
the spaces.
F A C E.
That spells face.
Do it again.
F A C E.
Faster.
F A C E. A special friend of mine. Learn their names and you'll do great. Come on everybody, let's celebrate. Spaces and lines.
Do it again.
Spaces and lines.
Now here are the names of the lines.
E G B D and F.
Again.
E G Every good boy
and girl
does fine. Every space and every line is a special friend of mine. Learn their names and you'll do great. Come on everybody, let's celebrate. Spaces and lines.
Do it again.
Spaces and lines. Spaces and lines. E-G-B-D-F. Spaces. F-A-C-E. Yeah!
That was great, everybody! Thanks so much for joining us here on The Music Show, where music is...
Get ready. Get ready.
All together now, you two.
Fundamental.
Clap it out. Syllables, sister syllables, they're what you get. When you take a word apart, we'd be miserable without syllables. They're what you get. When you take a word apart, count, count, count some syllables. Clap it out,
yeah.
Clap it out. This is how we rock with syllables. Clap it out, clap it out.
Mice, mice. Bake, bake. Cheese, cheese. Cakes, cakes.
Put it all together now.
Mice, bake, cheese, cakes.
One more time.
Mice, bake, cheese, cakes.
I guess a mouse would bake a cheesecake, right?
Syllables, sister syllables, they're what you get. When you take a word apart, we'd be miserable without syllables. They're what you get. When you take a word apart, count, count, count some syllables. Clap it out, clap it out. This is how we rock with syllables. Clap it out, clap it out.
Two syllables, let's do it.
Awesome, awesome. Hamster, hamster. Birthday, birthday. Party, party.
Put it all together, now.
Awesome hamster birthday party.
One more time.
Awesome hamster birthday party.
That was a crazy party.
Syllables, sister syllables, they're what you get. When you take a word apart, we'd be miserable without syllables. They're what you get. When you take a word apart,
come on.
Count, count, count some syllables. Clap it out, clap it out. This is how we rock with syllables. Clap it out, clap it out.
Three syllables, work it out.
Woo! Chimpanzee, chimpanzee. Volunteers, volunteers. Inspecting, inspecting. Chandeliers, chandeliers.
Put it all together now.
Chimpanzee, volunteers. Inspecting, chandeliers.
One more time.
Chimpanzee, volunteers. Inspecting, chandeliers.
I can see everything in here now.
Syllables, sister syllables, they're what you get. When you take a word apart, we'd be miserable without syllables. They're what you get. When you take a word apart, count, count, count some syllables. Clap it out, clap it out. This is how we rock with syllables. Clap it out, clap it out.
Four syllables get complex.
Invisible,
invisible.
Alligators,
alligators.
Appreciate,
appreciate.
Calculators,
calculators.
Ooh. Put it all together now.
Invisible, alligators. Appreciate, calculators.
One more time.
Invisible, alligators.
alligators appreciate calculators.
Oh, who knew they could count?
Syllables, sister the syllables, they're what you get. When you take a word apart, we'd be miserable without syllables. They're what you get. When you take a word apart, count, count, count some syllables. Clap it out, clap it out. This is how we rock with syllables. Clap it out, clap it out.
5 syllables, blow it up.
Vegetarian, vegetarian. Hippopotamus, hippopotamus. Evaluating, evaluating. Potato salad, potato salad.
Put it all together now.
Vegetarian, hippopotamus, evaluating. Potato salad.
One more time.
Vegetarian, hippopotamus, evaluating. Potato salad.
My evaluation of this potato salad is really great.
Syllables, just the syllables, they're what you get. When you take a word apart, we'd be miserable without syllables. They're what you get. When you take a word apart, count, count, count some syllables. Clap it out, clap it out. This is how we rock with syllables. Clap it out, clap it out.
Syllables.
Yeah, my mom's potato salad's better than your mom's.
Not really, but we'll see.
Hey, it's Dad's old trumpet. That's the spit valve. Dear Tim and Moby, what's so great about Louis Armstrong? From Roger. Louis Armstrong was probably the most popular and influential jazz musician in history. He was the first jazz superstar, helping it grow from a local style of dance music to a respected art form played by musicians all over the world. Louis Daniel Armstrong was born in New Orleans on August 4, 1901. He grew up in a poor neighborhood where he sang on the street for pennies. Well, his father abandoned the family when Louis was a baby, and his mom left him with his grandmother. Without much adult guidance, he got into his share of trouble with the police. But it was in a juvenile detention center that young Louis Armstrong learned to play the cornet, a brass instrument similar to the trumpet. By the age of 18, his musical talent and constant practice landed him a job in Kid Ory's band. It was considered the best hot jazz group in New Orleans. Hot jazz was an early form of jazz that emphasized improvisation. Each musician in the band would play his own variation on the melody. Yeah, it could sound pretty chaotic, but the best hot jazz musicians would weave their sounds together and create music that was both fun and original. Louis was a master of improvisation and soon became popular enough to strike out on his own. He moved to Chicago, where he made records with his own bands, the Hot Five and later the Hot Seven. On these famous recordings, Armstrong introduced the solo to jazz. During a solo, one musician improvises while the rest of the band stays silent or plays quietly in the background. Louis's recordings with the Hot Five and Hot Seven changed jazz forever. The solo soon became the centerpiece of all major styles of jazz music. Louis's records were huge hits, establishing him as an international star and introducing jazz to the world. Oh no, he didn't just play the trumpet. Armstrong pretty much invented jazz singing, too. His voice was gravelly, but he played with the rhythm and melody of lyrics just like they were notes from a trumpet. He also popularized scatting, the singing of nonsense sounds instead of actual words. What? Alright. Scoobity-wop, de-bop, de-bop. Anyway, over the years, Armstrong's celebrity just kept growing. He appeared in Hollywood movies, had his own radio show, and was even sent on a government-sponsored goodwill tour of the world. People started calling him Ambassador Satch after that. Well, his nickname was Satchmo, short for Satchel Mouth, because he had such a big mouth. The world came to love Satchmo as much for his smile and lighthearted personality as his music. He was just a lovable guy. And he loved his work. Louis played hundreds of shows a year up until his death in 1971. Well, I could give it a shot. Dad showed me some stuff once. Oh, cut that out. You did that on purpose. Moby?
Mm-hmm.
see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. Watch them grow, they're like much more than I never knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Boys and girls, it's time for us to say goodbye again. So let's sing our goodbye song together. Ready? So long, farewell to you, my friends. Goodbye for now, until we meet again. I said so long, farewell to you, my friends. Goodbye for now, until we meet again. It's been great to play and sing together, but now it's time to say goodbye. So long, farewell to you, my friends. Goodbye for now, until we meet again. Goodbye for now, until we meet again.